who's an assistant professor at the school, clinical assistant professor at the School of Journalism.
And as Nicole's coming up and setting up for her iPad, this is a perfect time to sort of get a plug in here for how Nicole got her iPad Classroom. First, she's pretty amazing and had an awesome idea. Second is she applied for the Digital First Impact Grant. Last year, we awarded two Digital First Impact Grants, one to Nicole and one to Jeffrey Parvin in the College of Medicine, who is in the Biomedical Sciences Graduate Program. I'm plugging all of this now because the grant window has opened. So the Digital First Impact Grant application is up on this website. It is go.osu.edu/dfgrant. The applications are due by April 7th. On the website, you will see a ton of information. There's a blog about both projects and how they are doing. And then the application is towards the bottom. So I encourage any of you that have faculty and staff, if you're not a faculty member yourself, that is interested in this and doing an iPad classroom, to go here and to fill out an application. Also at the same time, Henry Griffey's in the back, we also have an impact grant cycle going on. So we have two grants being awarded on April 7th, or applications due by April 7th, both the Digital First Impact Grants and our impact grants. So if you're interested in either contact myself or Henry, and we can provide a ton of information on these. So I'll hand it over to Nicole. Do you need audio as well? Yep.
Hi, how are you? So the first thing I wanted to, how I was going to start this changed yesterday. That's my son, by the way. Because I had a meeting with a student, and I met with her. I had her last semester in the first iPad classroom that we offered. As Corey mentioned, I did receive the first Digital First Impact Grant to put iPads in this particular class right here, which is Writing and Editing for News. So in this class, it's actually a pretty eclectic group of people. I'm in the School of Communication, and these are all, I put in quotes, journalism majors, but in fact, about out of 28 people, 16 of them are what are called agriculture communication students. A lot of them come from farms. They don't necessarily have some of the same goals and aspirations as our journalism students. They're technologically often not as familiar with some of the tools that we're using, but we always have a pretty festive time. So I had one student, her name is Gabby, she's adorable, and she fought me tooth and nail every single class period about the iPad. I hate the iPad, I don't want to use the iPad, I don't like the iPad, why are you making us use the iPad? We kept pushing through, the very first classes, and I'll talk to you about some of the challenges that we had that we recognize a little bit more this semester, about making sure that they feel comfortable before we ask them to do work on the iPad. But Gabby came and met with me yesterday. She's in magazine writing with me now, and she sat across from me and she did this big sigh. She said, "Nicole, I miss my iPad." She goes, "I want it back. Is there anything I could do to use the iPad that you let me use last semester?" And I say, "Gabby, I'm really sorry, but they're with the other class." And she's like, "I love it." And what it did for me is I was so organized with that iPad. I was so, everything I needed was with me. As soon as I forgot something, I knew it was in the iPad. I knew I could go to the iTunes U course, and if there was something you told us that I didn't remember, I could access that in the iPad. If there was an assignment that I wasn't sure what you had said about it while I was trying to rewrite it, it was in the iPad because I had edited it in the iPad and sent it back to her as a PDF, not only with my written comments on it, but with an audio file that they'd be able to access and hear my words about what they needed to do to revise. She knew that she could tweet me a question from the iPad, which I would receive almost instantaneously, and I would respond to her as quickly as possible, as opposed to her having to go to a computer and open up Hootsuite or open up Twitter or do any of that. So if I converted her without even intending to, because I got to be honest with you, after the first 3 weeks, I'm like, some people are grabbing hold of this and some people are not. We're going to all keep moving forward. But to see the look in her eye yesterday, I have no doubt that she will invest in an iPad as soon as she's financially capable of doing that. And I think that that's one of the bigger challenges that we're going to face if we don't make that commitment as a university to look at that. So I want to talk to you a little bit about what I've done with iTunes U and with the iPads, how it's changed philosophically, how I approach teaching. It's really interesting when I go places with Corey and Mike Hopper and we talk about that. Really, there was no real Digital First initiative until December of 2012. And in December of 2012 was when I met Corey and the rest of the wonderful Digital First people, because we were all, I applied to be one of the people who went to Apple for the iTunes U bootcamp that was held in Cupertino. And many people have heard me say this before, I did not own an iPad when I applied for that. I honestly had never heard of the term iTunes U before. I did not care. They had me at Go to Cupertino. So I would have done anything to be able to take that trip, and I really didn't care what it involved. I'm a Northern California native. I felt like I was going to Mecca if I went to Infinite Loop. And so I really didn't care about any of it until I started to utilize it. And I created my first course, which is Media Law and Ethics, which I have since relaunched as a better course. Oh, wrong one. I have four or five of them now, so it's hard to keep track. But this is Media Law and Ethics that I launched from that boot camp in December of 2012. And I sent it out into the world just for people to be able to use it. I bought an iPad right before we left on the trip to Cupertino, figuring I should probably be able to look at my own course. But I didn't really have any grasp as to how I would use it or how anyone else would use it until I made it available to my students, and they started to talk to me about how they were consuming materials, how they were able to access the slides whenever they wanted to, how they were able to study on their own time, how they were able to communicate with me when they wanted to. And the students who had iPads and were using the iTunes U course seemed to be more prepared to come in and discuss the key concepts with me than the people who were waiting for me to give them information in class and were relying solely on that experience. So I started thinking, there's something to be had here. So what I then found out pretty soon after about the Digital First Impact Grant, which I wrote a proposal for, and said that journalism is tailor-made for the iPad. Everything that we need to do as journalists can exist on the iPad. We need to write, take notes. Okay, I can record, or I can type, or I can hand write on the iPad. I need to be able to record audio and video. There's apps for that. I need to be able to interact with social media. There's apps for that. I need to be able to get in touch with sources. There's apps for that. Everything that we need to do could be done there. And then, how could I make the learning environment such that the entire encapsulation of this course, from assignment all the way through to the execution of that assignment, would exist in this iPad? And that came to me through iTunes U. And I said, I have to create an iTunes U course for this, and I have to take it beyond what the initial course was. So the initial course was a bunch of PowerPoints that I put up, and I felt really proud of myself for doing that. And then I realized, you know what, I'm wasting just a ton of time lecturing to these people. And when I was a kid, my God, my father would torture me with lectures. He didn't spank us or do any, I never was grounded, but he would lecture you for like an hour. And I'm like, oh my God, that's what I do. So I started to think, how could I make this something that would be more interactive with them utilizing this iPad technology? So again, meeting with Corey and Digital First, and we talked about apps like Explain Everything, and I realized I could flip the course entirely. So I could put all of the learning materials on there. I could create a flipped classroom whereby all of their lectures are accessible before they ever come to me. And now when they're sitting there struggling with their writing, or they're not sure about their AP style, or they're not sure how to do an interview, or they're not sure how to find a source, they could do all of that with me because they'll have learned the lectures beforehand. Then they're gonna come in and they're gonna do the hard part with me. We're gonna do it together. And that proposal was the one that got accepted for the Digital First Impact Grant, and that was the one that we launched in, what was that quarter? So August of 2013. Now, I would love to tell you that what we did was effortless and seamless, and it all worked out perfectly. I'll give you the good news first. The good news is that their scores absolutely improved. From the very first article that they wrote, their scores were was 1.7 points higher on those articles than the class before them had been. And their second article was even higher than that. Every subsequent article, there was a noticeable improvement in the scores that they received on those articles and the tests that they took. The only real testing assessment we do is in AP style and news consumption. And their AP style and news consumption was higher in that class. And that's despite the fact that I had an exponentially higher number of students who were not journalism majors per se. They were this agriculture communication major. So even though they may not have come with as much interest in journalism or as strong a background, their scores were infinitely higher. They were equipped to do things that no other class had been equipped to do because they had the iPad in their hands. And several people have heard this, and Corey's heard this story ad nauseum, that my pride and joy student up to that moment was my student Carly, who came in the third week at a point when normally we would have just been learning basic core journalism concepts, She came in and said, I have a story idea that's happening at the Union. DTIX is handing out tickets to the USA-Mexico game, and it's going badly. Like, there's something wrong over there, and I don't know what it is, but there's a story. And I didn't say another word to her. I said, go. I said, you can communicate with us on your iPad, tweet us, let us know what questions you have, take pictures, take notes, shoot video, do whatever you need to do with it. Go now. So she left the classroom, she went and reported that story for 2 hours, she interviewed people on her iPad, she recorded those interviews, she shot videos, she shot photos, she was writing the story, standing, like braced against a pillar in the Union. She's texting with me or tweeting with me, I'm editing her story while she goes, and within 3 hours that story was on the front page of the Lantern site, and the next day, it and the photo that she took from that iPad were on the front page of the Lantern. And that was the first journalistic experience that she'd ever had. So she was my pride and joy up to that moment. Now this semester, somebody did it in 2 weeks. And that's what they get out of it, is it's self-contained. And I can't stress that enough, that there's no notes for them to lose. There's no question as to what I said in a lecture. They can watch it as many times as they want to. There's no question about their book, because I wrote them a textbook that I put in the iPad that we sell for $2.99, so they're no longer buying a $79 journalism book, and anyone who knows anything about journalism knows that the second that book was contracted, it's out of date. So now they have up-to-the-minute information. If there's something breaking on any particular story, aspect of journalism, I'm plugging it into the iTunes U course, they're accessing it on the iPad, and they're reading it instantaneously. And all of that has proven to a great degree in the first semester, but even more so in this semester, that we are producing students who can move better, stronger, and faster toward their ultimate employment goals than they ever could when they were reliant on a multitude of tools.